fed sure gave me.
Solve the riddle, great and small.
Fed sure gave me.
Adventure games, he loves them all.
Every day is a new quest, exploring north, south, east, or west. Point and click to find the answers that we seek. Adventure Game Geek.
Hello there, fellow adventurers. After exploring the depths of Colossal Cave, I thought I'd go back to a time before graphic adventures were born, when there was just text on a screen. And even before that, as Stu from Stu's Game Reviews explains how this teletype machine works.
But you can see here how this game used to work back in the day. There wasn't even a computer screen, a TV screen, or anything like that. It was just this teletype. So the teletype machine would type out the prompt, and then use the keyboard to type in what you want to do, and then it would tell you what happens after that. So now it's basically saying, all right, don't blame me if it goes wrong, but I'll try to resurrect you, and poof.
The original Colossal Cave text adventure was released before I was born, so this era of adventure gaming mostly passed me by as a kid. I did play a few random text adventures, or interactive fiction as they're called, such as Jinxter and Nord and Bert Couldn't Make Head or Tail of It, but I didn't get very far in them. I'm not going to go into the history of text adventures here, so if you'd like to know more, I'd recommend the documentary Get Lamp by Jason Scott Sadowski. I'm also waiting for my copy of 50 Years of Text Games by Aaron Reed. In the meantime, I went on an archaeological expedition to a faraway land, Shingle Street in Suffolk, and unearthed some lost treasures. And for anyone wondering, no, I didn't just let that bag blow away in the wind.
I saved the waitress bag.
Yay!
After this discovery, I went to meet with someone who was there in the old days to tell us what it was like back then and delve into its mysteries.
Are you recording?
Yeah, I'm recording, yeah. We did that totally in sync.
3, 2, 1. Okay. So one of the awesome things about these games, you know, they didn't have graphics, but remember, graphics didn't exist then. But they knew that they were trying to develop this, basically a book that you could interact with.
Right.
And so just like a book has a cover, mm-hmm. right? They would include all of these different things in it.
Yeah, and like the box here kind of feels like a book. It's designed like a
exactly.
book.
Exactly, it's designed yeah. like a book.
Mm-hmm. What do we got?
There's the disc. Well, when they started releasing these things on home computers, these were the types of discs. These are 5 1/4 inch floppy discs. And later you'd have 3 1/2 inch ones. They were mm-hmm. smaller, but they actually stored more. So what they tried to do was give you all of these physical things that you could touch to mm-hmm. bring you into the world. So for example, this is a letter. I think someone is trying to kill me. I know this sounds dramatic, but I really am scared. You know, I've never believed in ghosts. But now I've actually seen the white lady. It was so frightening, right? So she's writing this letter to you and asking you, please come and help me. This is, it says moon mist, but you notice it's backwards.
Oh, yeah.
So have you ever seen one of these
yeah,
before?
Yeah, yeah, it's like a transfer.
It's an iron-on transfer.
Right.
This is for a t-shirt. All right, now that you're dressed. So the point of a lot of this stuff is to bridge the gap from the fictional world mm-hmm. into the real world. So there's tangible things that you can touch. So
okay, so yeah, so we got the letter, we got the t-shirt.
Here's a little welcome to Chesilian Castle. It's a little brochure about the castle. It tells you about the rooms. This one has a little bit of a map. Yeah. Most of the times the games would ask you to make your own map. And I'll tell you from experience, don't trust the maps that they give you.
No?
Because many times there are secret passageways that aren't on the maps.
Okay, all right. So the introduction here is you drove west from London all day in your new little British sports car. Now at last you've arrived in the storied land of Cornwall. Dusk has fallen as you pull up in front of Tresillian Castle. A ghostly full moon is rising and a tall iron gate between two pillars bars the way into the courtyard. What would you like to do? Okay. So
do whatever you want.
All right, open gate. It seems to be locked. What next? Unlock gate. Except for your rattling the gate, the silence remains unbroken. What next? Okay. I'm stuck already.
Well, just try going in cardinal directions.
All right, go north then. Oh, the castle is south of here.
Mm-hmm.
Let's try going east. The castle is south of here. West? The castle is south of here.
I'm beginning to suspect that the castle is south of here.
Is it not like an intercom or something?
Try that.
Yeah. Can we just look at the gate? Let's look at the gate.
Yeah.
In the moonlit gloom, you can make out an ornament on the gate. Ah, it's a winged two-legged dragon called a wyvern, which crests the Tressilian family's coat of arms. The dragon appears in profile. The moonlight glints on its lone visible eye. Aha. Push eye. The dragon's eye glows red. A voice comes from a hidden speaker. Nice. It says, please announce yourself. State your title, such as Lord or Lady, Sir or Dame, Mr. or Miss, and your first and last name. Did you say your name is Lord Adventure Game Geek?
Yes, I did. Yes, we did.
And what is your favorite color, Lord Adventure? All right, let's go south. Someone comes running out of the wing to greet you. She's a beautiful red-haired young woman of average height. You recognize her as your friend Tamara Lynn. Oh, is she the one that wrote the letters?
Yeah, she wrote the letters.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Overwhelmed by his friend Tamara's warm welcome, Lord Adventure Game Geek doesn't quite know what to say.
In general, when I'm a little lost, I try to look around at everything. So why don't you try that?
Isn't there a command, like, you know, when you're talking to people, isn't there a specific command, like, ask about something, or...?
Yes, it's ask about.
Oh, it's okay.
It's just...
Ask about...
About the white lady.
White lady.
Yeah.
Let's try that. I've told you all I know in my letter adventure, but come to think of it, there's an old history book in the library that tells about Tressilian Castle. You might learn more from that.
Tamara guides you into the foyer. As you enter the foyer, you're overwhelmed by the English past. Those barbarous times when Jack's ancestors had to shut themselves up in a fortified castle have softened into gracious country living. Yet Tamara is clearly anxious. My fiancé, Lord Jack Tressilian, Tamara introduces him. Jack, this is my friend from the States, Lord Adventure Game Geek. So you're the famous
nice
young...
Nice name.
it bespokes being a sleuth.
Ask about...
How about the White Lady? Oh, she has haunted Tressilian Castle for centuries. A lovely phantom in a white gown with long pale hair. She was said to be the unfaithful wife of an early Lord Tressilian who had her walled up alive in the tower.
She was walled up alive. Okay, so then she died.
Yeah, it was like in the story.
Right. Okay. Oh, so which story is that? Like the one that's included with the
one of the stories included in here called The Legendary Ghosts of Cornwall.
Mm.
There's one here.
There it is,
the White Lady
yeah.
at Tressilian Castle. Mm-hmm. It says, Sir Thomas accepted not this indiscretion. He banished Uther forever from the Cornish coast and ordered that his lady be bricked up alive within the cellar walls. The young bride perished in her agony. Shortly thereafter, a woeful spirit was seen flitting through the dark corridors of Tressilian Castle. Her long pale hair was loosed from its braid and a silvery white gown clothed her slender figure. To this day, the White Lady haunts the ancient tower, seeking a final resting place for her bones and lasting peace for her soul. So maybe we're supposed to find her body and leave her to rest.
After freshening up, Lord Adventure joins the other guests in the dining room.
Ask Jack about note.
Right. I have it right here, Lord Adventure. Lord Jack and his guests are startled as an unexpected voice suddenly speaks. Good evening, all, it says, and then breaks into a low chuckle. Good Lord, Jack gasps. That's Uncle Lionel's voice. Dr. Wendish points to the bronze bust. There's where it's coming from. The bronze bust is hollow. When you lift it from its shelf, you discover a small tape recorder underneath with an elaborate clockwork timer. Evidently, the timer was set to play the tape during the usual dinner hour on this date. You are all here, I trust, to honor the wish expressed in my will, that the seven of you should dine together at Tresellian Castle on the evening of my birthday. Mm-hmm. Lionel's voice continues, as you know, I enjoyed adventuring to remote corners of the world, and doubtless you've all heard of the loss of that valuable artifact which I brought back from one of my expositions. Have you not? Lionel's voice goes on, the truth is that the artifact is not lost, but hidden. Mm. Although I am not yet ready to reveal what it is, I suggest you look under the punch bowl.
Look under the punch bowl. All right, well, let's do that.
You have all been poisoned.
Look under punch bowl.
You find the first clue underneath, so you take it.
Oh, the first clue, right, okay.
The first clue shows a skeleton in Chinese Mandarin costume. Hmm. Lionel's voice finishes. So now, my friends, let the game begin.
Let the game begin.
Wait a minute. We've had like an hour and a half.
okay. So
what
now
are you talking about?
Now the game.
All right. Now it
begins.
Starts.
Okay.
Right.
Looking for the skeleton mentioned in the clue, Lord Adventure makes his way to the dungeon. Right. We're now in the dungeon. All right.
Oh, woohoo! Dungeon. Okay,
another exit is east of the basement. The light reveals an Iron Maiden here.
Iron Maiden? Excellent!
As you step on the bottom of the Iron Maiden, it sinks downward into the secret tomb. You step out again. You feel a cold shiver run down your back. You are now in the secret tomb.
Okay, let's open... Well, this is... Hang on. Examine the coffin. You open the stone coffin first. It is empty. Oh, that's disappointing.
Finding nothing else of interest in the dungeon, Lord Adventure heads back upstairs.
Light comes from the first floor corridor. This small office gets little light and less air. In one corner is a computer. Well, we are definitely not in 1940.
In one computer? This can't be in the 1940s.
It might be 1983 then, or 1986.
Oh, let's see what's on the computer.
There's a lot of stuff here,
Maybe we can play an Infocom game.
Ooh.
It'd be funny if we could play Moon Mist in Moon Mist.
It starts running an interactive called The Witness, but you decide that Moon Mist is easier, so you turn it off.
Examine books.
Yeah, or bookcases. Or some of the books date back as far as the 16th century. Although some are fiction, most of the books are scientific, covered with vellum or leather. A history book catches your eye.
Right, that must be the one. As you move the history book, the bookcase creaks open, revealing a secret passage.
God damn it.
Like, okay, well,
I wanted to read the book.
Oh, it's too dark to see. Okay.
Yeah, you were likely to be eaten by a Gru.
Oh, so what's a Gru?
To understand what a Gru is, we must consult the field guide to the creatures of Froboz.
The Gru is a sinister, lurking presence in the dark places of the Earth. Its favorite diet is enchanters, but its insatiable appetite is tempered by its fear of light. No Gru has ever been seen by the light of day, and few have survived its fearsome jaws to tell the tale. Toxicologists believe that Grus are black and black and red and black and purple. I don't even know what color that is.
Going through the secret passage, Lord Adventure sneaks into one of the women's bedrooms to go through their things. Look for more clues.
Iris's bedroom is furnished much like yours, but with a canopied bed and a love seat. Mm. And a wide open secret door.
Sit in love seat.
You are now sitting on a love seat.
The door burst
open, Iris appears. She stares you with a shocked look. Well, I didn't expect my room to be searched, she says angrily. She enters the room and closes the door behind her.
Oh, she's angry.
Interesting.
She's angry that we're sitting in her love seat.
All right, we gotta talk to her.
She is peeved with you. What is she peeved about though?
You're in her room.
Yeah, but you know, like.
There's a secret door. Well, you were watching her through the peephole.
Right.
What's there not to be mad at you about?
What's wrong with that? I'm kind of at a loss what to do. Mm-hmm. It's very non-linear, isn't it?
At a loss for how to solve the mystery, we decided to consult the hint book for clues.
What does this say? How do I protect Tamara from the vampire? What vampire?
Did you find the coffin hidden in the secret tomb?
It must be in the secret tomb.
You'll need a wooden cross from the chapel and garlic from the kitchen. Find a sharp stick in the lumber. Okay.
See, I...
Up! What vampire? There's no vampire in Moon Mist.
Oh, no, they're just kidding. See, I was sure about that. See, what did I say? I was like, I bet Dracula is in that coffin.
That was freaking hilarious.
They totally trolled me.
They trolled everybody.
Yeah.
I got caught in someone else's bedroom and now I can't leave. Oh. It isn't polite to snoop around other people's bedrooms. The other guest is probably mad at you for doing so. You should apologize to the guest.
Oh, that's what we had to do. Okay. Why did I not think of that? I just have to apologize.
Someone is ignoring me. What does this mean? Were you rude to the person earlier? Maybe you ignored a question or hit or insulted him or her. You should apologize to the guest. You freeze the door when Vivian appears. She stares at you with a shocked look. Well, I didn't expect my room to be searched, she says angrily. She enters the room and closes the door behind her. Apologize.
Okay, now we're gonna apologize. Apology
accepted.
Apology accepted, Lord Adventure.
Apology accepted, Captain Nida.
After apologizing to Vivian, Lord Adventure goes right back to rummaging through her Necker drawer.
Inside the wooden box are a shimmering white gown and blonde wig. Congratulations, Lord Adventure, you've identified the ghost.
Woo!
Yeah.
All right, try a score.
Oh, yeah, let's see. Did we get any points for that?
Well, so far you've met Lord, Jack, and all the guests, worn the proper outfit to dinner.
Yeah, okay.
Discovered
good.
Secret passages, yeah. Identified the ghost, but nice. You haven't found the hidden treasure nor enough evidence of why Vivian haunted Tressilian Castle.
All right, so what are we going to play next then?
Well, I think you're used to adventure gaming. Is that not correct, Lord Adventure Gamer? So let's try one of the earliest adventure games ever made.
Oh yeah, what's that then?
Zork. Originally released as Dungeon.
Uh-huh.
Back on those old mainframes. It was a gigantic game. It was over a meg. If you can believe that.
Oh my god, over a meg.
Something as large as a meg.
That's huge.
Well, you might think that's a small amount, but remember
it was a lot back in the day. Right.
A meg is a 1,000K, and home computers had between 20 and 30K of memory. So they split it into three parts. The first part is a pretty standard dungeon crawl. You're running around trying to collect treasure, fight some monsters, solve puzzles. You know, very, very straightforward adventure game type of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So this game does not have a lot of background. So there was this king who was insane with power.
Hmm.
And he instructed the building of all of these caves. So excavations down there, rooms were built down there, buildings were down there, because he figured that, like, if this is my land, but then I have layers underneath that, I've got five times the kingdom.
All right, Zork 1. Okay, so the Great Underground Empire.
Yep.
Right. That's it.
Those words chill me to my soul.
Which words are those?
West of house.
West of house?
You are standing in an open field west of a white house with a boarded front door. There is a small mailbox here.
I guess open the mailbox, right?
Opening the small mailbox reveals a leaflet. Zork is a game of adventure, danger, and low cunning. In it, you will explore some of the most amazing territory ever seen by mortals. No computer should be without one.
Let's go east.
You're behind the White House. A path leads into the forest to the east. In one corner of the house, there is a small window which is slightly ajar.
Okay. Climb through window.
You are in the kitchen of the White House. A table seems to have been used recently for the preparation of food. A passage leads to the west, and a dark staircase can be seen leading upward. A dark chimney leads down, and to the east is a small window which is open.
Let's go up.
Okay. Mm-hmm. You have moved into a dark place. It is pitch black. You are likely to be eaten by a Gru.
What does that mean? What's a Gru?
You are likely to be eaten by a Gru. If this predicament seemed particularly cruel, consider whose fault it could be. Now the torture a match in your inventory.
Oh no, you have walked into the slavering fangs of a lurking Gru. You have died. Now let's take a look here. Well, you probably deserve another chance. I can't quite fix you up completely, but you can't have everything.
Climb tree.
Oh, we're up a tree.
Up a tree. You're about 10 feet above the ground, nested among some large branches. The nearest branch above you is above your reach. Beside you on the branch is a small bird's nest. In the bird's nest is a large egg encrusted with precious jewels.
Oh my god, this is like King's Quest now. I feel kind of bad for taking the egg, but...
Well, your score did go up by 5 points.
All right, I'm okay with that.
Try going up again. Clearing. You're in a clearing with a forest surrounding you on all sides. A path leads south. On the ground is a pile of leaves.
Jump in leaves.
Very good. Now you can go to the second grade.
That was good.
In disturbing the pile of leaves, a grating is revealed.
Oh.
Taken. I drew a picture of it.
I thought this game was supposed to all take place underground, though.
Nope. I will mention you have not fully explored the house.
Oh, well, wait, what didn't I... Like, did I take the passage west or no? Maybe I didn't.
Oh, you did not.
I didn't even go west.
You went up into the dark.
I went up and down. I didn't go west. Okay.
You are in the living room. There is a doorway to the east, a wooden door with strange Gothic lettering to the west, which appears to be nailed shut. A trophy case and a large oriental rug in the center of the room. With a great effort, the rug is moved to one side of the room, revealing a dusty cover of a closed trapdoor.
All right.
I'll remind you, you're carrying a lot of stuff right now.
Oh, okay, and so is there a limit to what you can carry here?
Oh, yes.
Okay.
Oh, yes. This is the attic. The only exit is stairway leading down. A large coil of rope is lying on the corner. On a table is a nasty-looking knife.
Ah, rope and knife, always useful. Okay, can we take all?
Yes.
All right, we took the nasty knife. It's not just a knife, it's a nasty.
It's a nasty knife.
Is there a combat in this game? Like, if you have a sword, like, do you get to use it?
I don't know. I forgot.
You sit on a throne of lies.
All right. So let's go west, and then let's open the trap door. The door reluctantly opens to reveal a rickety staircase descending into darkness. Oh, could this be the entrance to the underground, maybe?
You have moved into a dark place. The trapdoor crashes shut and you hear someone barring it. It is pitch black. You're likely to be eaten by a group.
Oh my god.
A lean and hungry gentleman just wandered through carrying a large bag. Finding nothing of value, he left disgruntled. Your sword is glowing with a faint blue glow.
Are there like orcs around or something?
Orcs!
Troll room. This is a small room with passages to the east and south. And a forbidding hole leading west.
I want to go west.
Bloodstains and deep scratches, perhaps made by an axe, mar the walls. A nasty-looking troll brandishing a bloody axe blocks all passages out of the room.
Oh my god. All right. Okay. Right. Well...
I'm sorry. When you asked before, is there combat, I should have said yes.
You disgust me. How can you live with yourself?
The troll is battered into unconsciousness.
Oh, okay. There we go.
The unarmed troll cannot defend himself. He dies.
I just killed the troll. I want to go into the forbidding hole, so I want to go west.
Maze. This is part of a maze of twisty little passages, all alike.
Oh, okay, there's no directions? Okay, let's go west again. North?
You notice I'm not mapping.
There's nothing to map. Oh, we're back in the troll room.
Woo! If every place that you go to,
yeah,
has exactly the same description.
Mm-hmm.
What can make each individual room, which looks exactly the same, be unique?
Drop. drop rope. Yeah, okay, okay, we drop the rope.
Now take a look.
There is a rope here. Yeah. Well, what, so you drop an item in every room?
Yep.
Okay, so now, so we dropped our lunch, so now
okay.
A hot pepper sandwich is here.
Okay, so we went west to go into this room. Try going back east.
Okay. Okay, so this is now the knife room.
Okay.
This is the nasty knife room.
So up takes you to the skeleton room.
Oh, that's the skeleton room?
That's the skeleton
room.
Okay,
great. Let's go.
So you're still in the rope room, right?
Okay, let's go west to the hot pepper sandwich room.
Right, Wes's lunch room.
Let's go up, no, down,
nope.
No.
Okay.
Oh, this maze. My God.
It hates you. They did warn you that was a forbidding hole leading west.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, okay.
All right, we have a new room. What are we going to call this room?
The garlic room. Let's drop the garlic then, I guess.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, that is a clove of garlic, believe it or not.
I'm running out of things to drop here.
I'm aware of this.
Okay, drop key. So this is the skeleton key room.
Look how nice that skeleton key is. That's amazing.
That is pretty good, actually. But the whole of the underground empire isn't like this, right? This is just...
No, this is one section.
This is like one section. All right, so...
So we're in the skeleton key room.
Okay, let's try going up. Oh, what, it's another room?
New room. Yeah, see? Easy to follow.
look at that map.
Totally easy to follow. Makes absolute sense.
That's crazy.
These games were designed for a puzzle like this to take you all night to figure out.
Uh-huh.
Like, it wasn't like, oh, we finish a game in 2 hours. I don't think we've gone north from here.
No? Okay. You can't go that way.
Good. Okay. So all of these are good. We didn't try down.
We spent so long exploring the maze of twisty little passages all alike that we only had time to try out one more lost treasure.
All right, so Ballyhoo.
You're getting more and more removed from reality, aren't you?
It's getting crazy now.
So Ballyhoo is a story about a circus.
Mm-hmm. Right?
So there's a big circus pulls into town. After the circus has had its big show, everyone's left. So you kind of hide and you're waiting for things to go by. As you trudge along in the wake of the outflowing crowd, you thumb through your memories of the evening. Your experience of the circus, with its ballyhooed promises of wonderment and its ultimate disappointment, has been to sink your teeth into a candy apple whose fruit is rotten. The Big Top can be entered to the north and exited to the south. To the northeast, the grandstand begins its precipitous rise.
Mm.
All right, so this is in the wings.
This is the arena's oval-shaped performance ring, which is occupied by a sagging rectangular safety net. A rope ladder dangles to within a foot of the ground. How about we try climbing the ladder?
Well, I'm sure you can walk across the tightrope.
Let's walk the tightrope. Let's do it.
You are standing perched nakedly high above the arena floor, a couple of baby steps across the tightrope. Walking a tightrope.
When I read that, I read perched naked.
So did I. You take a couple of tentative steps across the wire, reaching the halfway point. A quiver shoots through your leading foot, stopping you dead on the wire. You find yourself leaning almost imperceptibly to the north. Ta-da! Those familiar notes from tonight's show reverberate through your body in triumph. Platform.
Nice.
You're standing on a small, unstable platform, which is suspended high above the arena floor. Floating against the ceiling of the Big Top is a helium balloon, which looks like this.
I'm kind of afraid to blow this up.
You shouldn't.
I don't think
it'll work.
It doesn't look like it's...
But even if it would, then it will be destroyed for all time.
All right, here we go. I'm going to attempt to blow up this balloon here. And just hope it doesn't break.
Oh,
It's not blowing up at all.
We crawled under the bleachers and played around in the garbage, shouting, "Fiddle dee dee, rot rubbish figs!"
Your foray into garbage reclamation pays off as you turn up the unmarked ticket of some luckless circus.
Oh,
guard.
Okay, there was something. Yeah, it's like that ticket. Yeah, like the ticket there, right?
Did you take it?
Let's take it. Take ticket. Yes.
So you're a ticket taker. So this this is supposed to be the ticket for getting in. It has a couple of things on it. For one thing, it has a little section. You can pop out the blue M if you're male, and pop out the pink F if you're female. There you go. So
insert ticket in slot.
All right. I feel good about that.
And
I solved that one.
Okay. And that's how you get to the midway.
And that is how you get to the midway. All right, so midway entrance.
Okay, we should probably leave it there.
And we got into the midway.
Yeah. Yeah, like text adventures are really hard work, but I think they pay off, you know.
They are. I mean, I agree with you. A lot of times you can't even figure out what the puzzle is.
Mm.
But you notice when we were really stuck, we're like, okay, that there has to be something here. And then when we got to the bleachers, there's garbage everywhere. Okay, search the garbage. Okay, we found the ticket. And then when we came back and actually looked at the turnstile, that's when we noticed there's a slot.
Yeah.
And then we thought, well, what does somebody normally do? They would put a ticket into that slot to let them through.
Yeah, so you know, like that makes sense. Like, yeah, when you think about it.
But we didn't see it at all until we started examining things. Hmm. So with a graphic adventure, you can typically see everything that's there.
Mm.
With this, since it's text, you have to put the pieces together.
All right.
Yeah, pretty cool.
So that's it, right?
Again, I don't know. You okay. Tell me. This is,
yeah, that's it.
This is your show.
And so, after spending all day and night playing, we only just scratched the surface of this 20-game collection. So there's a lifetime of adventuring here for those who wish to explore it further. This has been an Adventure Game Geek presentation, part of the Adventure Game Hotspot Network. Join me next time when I answer the question I'm sure you've been asking since my last update.
And, that's also Fable. And that's Fable. Yeah, I have 3 copies of Fable. Don't ask.
This predicament seemed particularly cruel. Consider whose fault it could be. Now the torture, a match in your inventory.